My dad and I were the father and son team out in West Texas when Baptists had simultaneous revivals. One place he'd give his testimony and I'd preach, and then I'd give my testimony and he'd preach. But out there I met an old boy whose dad was in the car business, Chevrolet dealer, I believe. And this kid told me about this man called Max Barnett that I ought to meet, because he said, I believe that you and he are talking the same language. Well, I said, where is he? He said, well, he's in Fort Worth. I said, what's he doing in Fort Worth? He said, well, he has a big house down there and has some guys living with him that he's training. I thought, hark, I better go meet this man. So I wandered off down there and met Max and met some of the guys he was working with. Learned that Max had been at Texas A&M. He didn't know the Navigators existed. And when he found out, he said, well, my goodness, here's the outfit's been doing what I've been doing, and I didn't know they even existed. So here he is training men. And then I had a call that he was in the hospital, sick. So I drove down there to see him, you know, walked into his room, and there old Max was laying up in bed, had a big black Bible under his pillow. I said, Max, what are you doing with that book under your pillow? He said, oh, that's my Jesus book. I said, well, what in the world are you doing with a Jesus book in the hospital? He said, well, in case I wake up and want to read it. And I thought to myself, I believe that old boy will do. And that started our relationship. And he'd get me down there to Dallas every once in a while, get his guys together in a motel room, and I'd preach at him. We'd have a good time together.